Today we're going to talk about the importance of habit and the 7-step daily routine for high performance traders. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. G'day traders, I'm Stacy Burke from Stacy Burke Trading. Hopefully this video finds you going well and your trading is moving forward on track with the goals that you're after with trading. Today we're going to talk about the power of habit. I just recently went through Charles Duhigg's book, The Power of Habit, and I got some great little tidbits that sort of tied in with some of the other things that I had developed when I put together the 7-step daily routine for high performance traders. If you haven't done so, go to my homepage, download. It's an audio file. You can take it wherever you go. It's a blueprint for you to use to bulletproof yourself on a daily basis for constant progress in your trading. We're going to talk about why that's so important. Everybody already has a daily routine, but whether or not the routine that you're currently using or the routine that you're living is actually helping you move forward in the goals that you're after is another story. So all the little things that we do on a daily basis, essentially one of the things that came out of the book was that all habits have a 3-step process and they have cues that trigger them. And then they become routines, and that culminates in some kind of reward. Now, one of the things that I have found with talking and dealing with a lot of traders in my own experience trading, and I've talked about this over and over and over again, and blowing up small accounts and doing the same things over and over again, but I loved trading. I loved being at the screen. I loved the charts. I loved studying the markets. I loved studying the charts. I still do. And I think part of that was, some of those cues. Some of the trading mistakes that I made were in the routine that I had about getting on the screen and doing certain behavioral things. And then regardless if I won or lost money, there was a reward of satisfaction that triggered parts of the brain that released dopamine and gave a pleasure effect just because I was trading at the screen. So all cues have all these cues fall into these categories. Location triggers, time triggers, emotional triggers, actions of other people triggers, and the last action that preceded that cue from taking place. So again, I can certainly remember, and I'm sure a lot of traders can. There's certain behavioral characteristics. Maybe you're at work, or maybe you get home and you get into your desk chair, you relax, you get on the screen. You put the charts up, you want to take a trade. Maybe you're angry. Maybe you're euphoric. Maybe you've had a good night out, you've had a few drinks, and you think you'll get on the screen and make a few trades. Or somebody's upset you or got you angry or frustrated. You don't like your job, you don't like your boss, you don't like your current profession, and so you want to get out. There's reasons that you're so desperate to get away from that situation that some of those emotions trigger that reaction. Actions of other people. Maybe you've got a work colleague or somebody close to you who maybe doesn't believe in you, or they've ridiculed you, or you just can't stand them, or you want to impress somebody. And again, last action that preceded the cue. You might be doing certain things that trigger, again, a routine that culminates in some kind of reward from taking place. So one of the things they talked about were keystone habits as well. And keystone habits were little habits that triggered bigger habits. So they talked about people who went through weight loss, who were struggling with weight loss. And one of the biggest things that they found, one of the most powerful exercises that they had them conducting was journaling. And what a lot of the people found was that there were certain behavioral characteristics that were leading them to binge eating or to overeating or to eating certain foods. And I've harped on this with the trading. And I'll say this again, I can't emphasize enough to every individual to be journaling, whether it's a handwritten note, again, putting your trades into something like EdgeWonk. If you haven't done so, grab the free trial on the link. I do a daily diary, I screenshot my trades and I write a couple of short notes on one page. That's separate from the EdgeWonk because I put my trade sheet in at the end of the month and I'm still using it for pretty basic stuff, but essentially even that is having some kind of record keeping, even if it's handwritten or typed in, is a powerful process because not only is there a kinesthetic input into your neuroplasticity through writing it. There's a visual one and an auditory one if you're saying it out loud. So again, certain things will reinforce small wins that can lead to bigger habits. And we're going to talk about that in a second. So one of the big things that I've put together with the 7-step daily routine was this. Again, I go back and I say this over and over again. You already probably have a routine. And a lot of traders, myself included, we search for the holy grail of entries and exits. We're convinced, like if you search on Google, the biggest amount of search traffic for trading, especially Forex trading, Bitcoin, whatever else, is they're looking for a system, a strategy. But and I've harped on this in other videos, you can have a very simple strategy if as long as you have predefined your risk and you've got some kind of asymmetrical risk reward or a high hit rate with your trades, chances are you're going to blow up your account if you don't have that otherwise. But you know, talk about the vision. What is it? Who is it that you want to become? Who is the trader that you want to become in terms of not only how you implement and flawlessly execute your trading system, but how you are in other areas of your life as well. You know, I talk about mindset training because trading is going to challenge you. It's going to inflict pain upon you. It's going to be one of the most frustrating experiences you're ever going to encounter. So it's critical that you bulletproof yourself mentally on a day-to-day basis to get yourself prepared to handle that, but also be resilient enough to come back, you know, to manage your risk, to hit the next trade, to execute your trading plan according to the strategy that you've laid out. You know, I think exercise and health is a huge component of that. I exercise in the mornings every single day. I never miss a day. And part of that is that because it's super physically, obviously I want to look after myself, but it supercharges your brain. It only takes 20 minutes to release the feel-good chemicals. Now, I like to do an afternoon run after London's been open for a few hours, but I really think the healthier you are, the clearer your thought process is, the more clarity you have in your thinking, the more relaxed you are at the screen. But generally, I think it ties a lot of other things together because the mind, how the mind goes, you know, everything else will follow. Setting your goals each week, each month, every 30 days, every 90 days, whatever that is, journaling your trades, journaling your every day, I said to write a sentence, one new thing that you've learned every single day. Just I type mine up on Google Docs. Accelerate your learning. I go through my playbook. I run through the charts from the previous day. I do my screenshots. I take my notes. I test. I always go through about 10 or 11 trades every morning in that what I call my genius time. That's the time that's quiet in the house. I got three young kids. They're still asleep. I get up. I have my water and lemon. I love my espresso. Probably have a couple shots of that. I like to get on the front of the computer. I don't do anything else. I don't check emails. I don't do any of that stuff till later. And then I run through my playbook. And again, the more you focus on building your playbook, the simpler you can make your strategies. You're going to get some little nuggets along the way. I keep saying that. You know, I'm always, even with my mindset training, I'm rereading, listening to Peter Brandt, rereading some of his books, Brent Penfold. I'm always looking and reading from other traders, especially there's some great podcast chat with traders, Better System Trader. But there's just a wealth of information out there to tie all this together. And when you're doing that on a daily basis, you're getting small wins. You know, you're less likely. And hopefully what you are doing also is eliminating bad habits or bad cues that were leading to routines that were possibly culminating maybe in the reward that you're getting by sitting at the screen, but not necessarily in the P&L in your trading account. And that's what this is about. I mean, I love trading, but I love making money. And that's what, you know, the trading's, you know, we're all here, obviously, to make money trading, but trading is going to be the hardest way to make easy money. Create small wins, traders, build them into bigger ones, get better at them, trade bigger, trade smarter, and may the markets go with you. Hopefully you had some value from today's video. Create the habits that you're after and the results that you want in your trading. Eliminate or minimize the bad habits. Stay disciplined, stay focused, and may the markets go with you.
Hi traders, it's Stacy Burke from Stacy Burke Trading. If you haven't done so, please head over to my website at stacyburketrading.com. I create updates on almost a daily basis and I would love for you to receive them. Just click on the blog. If you want to enter your name and your email address, I'll send you my free audio program, The 7-Step Daily Routine for High Performance Traders. This is essential knowledge for all traders in all markets, and this is for helping traders to master the market with discipline, confidence, and a winning mindset. I appreciate all your feedback and comments. As always, traders, stay disciplined, and may the markets go with you.